We're providing you with an asset drop via the link below, so you can download the images and include them in the app. When we open up the asset zip file, we see that the same icon is provided at different sizes for different resolutions. In the drawable MDPI folder, we see the assets that will be used on an MDPI device. In the drawable HDPI folder, we see the assets that will be used on an HDPI device. And the same goes for the other folders. Under the res directory, copy over all the asset folders provided in the download. Clicking on an image shows a preview of it, and the size in pixels is also shown. At this time, you can also remove the old placeholder IC launcher icons. Our new launcher icons are located in MITMAP folders. These are distinct folders from the drawable folders. If you build an APK for a target screen resolution, like HDPI, the Android Asset Packaging Tool, AAPT, can strip out the drawables for other resolutions that you don't need. But if it's in the MITMAP folders, then these assets will stay in the APK regardless of the target resolution. But when would you need an image at a resolution different than the resolution of the device? Well, one example is the Android Launcher app, which controls the home screen as well as the All Apps drawer. The Launcher app won't use the icon at the current density of the device, but rather pulls the icon for the next highest resolution up. For an XX HDPI device like the Nexus 5, normally the assets will be pulled from the drawable XX HDPI folder. However, in this case, the launcher icon will pull the XXX HDPI version of the launcher icon. That will make the larger app icons appear sharper on the All Apps screen. In the code, replace @drawableICLauncher with @mitmapICLauncher because of the new location of the icons. For the rest of the icons, modify the forecast list and the details screen to display the right weather icon instead of the placeholder one. See the hints below in the instructor notes. Using the helper functions we've provided in the gist below, you can map the weather condition code to the icon that you'll need. This is what the app should look like when you're done with this step. Note that there are two types of each weather icon, a gray icon and a colored art image. In the main forecast list, we'll be using the gray icon. However, for the today layout, we'll use the colored icon. When you go inside the detail activity, you'll also use the colored icon. At this time, you can also remove any images you hard-coded into the layout XML because they'll be populated dynamically now.